A section of members of parliament have expressed disappointment with the administration of the house for chopping their pay by 1 million shillings to contribute to the Jacob Olanya Education Trust Fund, which was created to take care of education of the needy children that were being taken care of by the late speaker.
Just got shocked when I got information reliably, not rumor, but reliably, that they had cut 1 million from each member of parliament to go to Jacob Olanya Foundation. When I tried to inquire from some colleagues, they said one time they were having a sitting and they passed a resolution that each member should pay 1 million towards Jacob Olanya Foundation. But you see, sometimes I don't want to blame the leadership of parliament and others, but we are setting a precedent which is wrong. Because there must be parameters. This is the contribution towards the foundation of an individual. It's not national. It's not in national interest.
And I disagree completely, because I should have appended a signature for my money to be cut. I have not yet gotten facts whether it has been cut. But if it has, I did not append or accept my money to go to a fund where I don't know how the money is going to be utilized.
They have questioned the procedure that was used to cut their money without their consent.
Cut people's money like that, you get it. Issues concerning money must consent. We don't agree on money cutting like the eyes have it. Assuming I was not in the parliament, did I say I? There is no collective responsibility in cutting money. If I have to contribute towards Jacob Olanya Foundation, I must sign as an individual, sign on that form. So the right procedure would have been for them to circulate a paper, a document, so that we sign.
We have challenges in our different electoral areas. Every morning, I receive over 20 people in need of school fees, in need of upkeep, and I think I can better utilize that money in my own constituency, because there are very many, many people that are lacking.
But some legislators are okay with the initiative by Parliament to contribute to the welfare of dependents of the former Speaker of Parliament. They believe the former Speaker, Jacob Olanya, deserves the contribution due to his gallant service to Parliament and the country at large.
Even in a democratic world, you go with the majority. What democracy detects is what you go with. In Parliament, we live by the motion. A motion was moved on the floor of Parliament, and it was passed, that every member of Parliament will contribute at least 1 million to the education fund of our befallen hero. And once you assent to that motion, or you had a contrary view, you are bound to what? To the contribution. So the contribution was made, but it was made in good faith. In Africa, we live in a social kind of setup. Today, it's me, tomorrow it's you. Yeah, it was our brother, then we don't know who tomorrow it's going to be.
The spokesperson of Parliament, Chris Obore, noted that the decision to cut MPs' pay by 1 million shillings was done following a resolution of Parliament to contribute to the trust fund. He called on MPs not to blow the matter out of proportion.
As a member of Parliament, who is against the late Speaker Jacob Olanya, may I take this opportunity to tell him or her that it is not wise to hate even the dead. It is not wise to hate the dead, because all of us end dead anyway. The decision for members of parliament to support the education fund was debated in the House and a resolution made.
Report by Fred Kajubi for the news.